I have missed dressing up in these lockdowns more than I can say. Mm. And I know that you love a bit of a dress up too. I used to go into my office sometimes on my own with a dress on, thigh-high Prada boots, just to make myself feel better. How have you been managing, particularly during the first lockdown, how did you manage?
Do you know, I think at first it was quite a novelty, wasn't it? You know, nobody going to work, kids not going to school, time at home or together. It was quite a novelty. And, you know, right from the beginning, you know, for me, I love to dress up like you. I love to dress up. I love to put makeup on. I love to do my hair. It's who I am. I don't just dress up to look a certain way for other people. I do it because it makes me feel good about myself. So, you know, obviously I was a little bit more relaxed at home, but I still wanted to make an effort. You know, I wasn't going to automatically put on sweatpants, you know, even if they are very nice Reebok sweatpants. I wasn't going to just, you know, give up and put on an elastic waist belt. So,
and one assumes David doesn't like you in too many saggy, elasticated sweatpant looks.
I don't know, I mean, he likes me to dress casually, but yeah. You know, every day I was still working, I was still getting up, I was on Zoom calls like everybody else, and you know, I'm quite a cheerleader, and I think when things started to get difficult, you know, when the weather wasn't so great and the novelty had worn off, you know, I'm a bit of a cheerleader for the family, and I wanted to wake up every morning and be positive, and I did feel very positive. And so for me to put on, you know, nice clothes and put a bit of makeup on, look, I'm not saying I was wandering around the house in super high heels, you know, I don't want to shatter the illusion there, but you know, I still wanted to make a bit of an effort because I was still working.
Yeah. And how are you communicating with your staff? I found particularly in the dark winter months, I put makeup on every day. I mean, apart from the horror of sort of having to look at yourself on Zoom the whole time, I felt that if you lead a team, you needed to put your best foot forward and, as you say, sort of look positive and in control. How were you communicating, and were you putting a bit of extra eyeliner on to make sure you look together, as it were?
You know, for me, really communicating with everybody who worked with me across both beauty and fashion was really, really key. Staying connected, because I think a lot of people were uncertain, a lot of people were nervous, a lot of people were scared and lonely, and so I worked very closely with my team. So to spend a lot of time, you know, on Zoom, yes to the extra eyeliner, I make a great one, which I was very thankful for. You know, great caps when your hair's not looking great. Sunglasses if you've had too much wine the night before, which I think a lot of us did during lockdown as well. That's okay too. You know, got to embrace all of that. I think a lot of us made more of an effort from the waist up.
Yeah, sometimes there are pyjamas below.
Than we did. My husband in particular, there were a few Zoom calls that I caught him on where he literally had a shirt and tie
and some shorts
here and his pants, you know. And the people that he was on Zoom to would have probably been quite surprised had they seen the full look.
Yeah.
But I think that that's what everybody did.
Yeah,
right? That's what everybody did.
Everybody.